100° field of view and a 4K resolution in one headset? This technology seemed impossible 2 years ago, yet Pimax seemed to be able to prove many wrong and many had doubts before. So in this second episode of Dive into VR, we went out and checked out the two Pimax headsets, 5K Plus and 8K, and in this video we'll let you know our first impressions. Coming up.
In case you don't know Pimax yet, they are a VR hardware manufacturer based in China. What makes their headsets special is their 200° field of view and higher resolution. They started out on Kickstarter and reached the goal 2 years ago. Now, about 2 years later, they have started to ship consumer units to backers.
So, Cass and I went to this small city called Gouda, or Gouda. I don't know how to pronounce that city name.
In English, it's hard. I would say Gouda, yes.
Gouda.
It's a small little city, like really small. It's a village, and they are famous for their cheese. Is that why you are wearing yellow today?
Yeah, I thought about that one. Yellow, the color of cheese.
So why did we go to Gouda then? Why Gouda, of all places?
I'll answer that one. Because VR Space organized an event for the Pimax, I would say backers, but also pre-buyers, people place pre-orders, so they could check out the 5K and 8K headsets and compare them and choose which one they want.
Yes, yes. And actually VR Space is an innovation lab. Their goal is actually to create awareness about virtual reality because they are very excited about the technology, just like us. So I thought that was pretty cool.
Yeah, we have the same goal. So what if we check out exactly what the 5K and 8K Pimax headsets?
Yes, and Sviva was there too.
Ooh, Sviva.
Always nice to meet him again, right? We should probably talk about what the setup was like over there.
Yeah.
So they had two PCs over there. They were both equipped with 1080 Ti's video cards. The 8K headset had a high-end i7 CPU, and the other PC with the 5K Plus headset on it had a lower-end i7 CPU. I don't know exactly the types, but that's the general setup that they had over there. So what games did we try again?
So Cass tried out Skyrim, and we also both tried out a racing game. Not totally sure which one that was though.
Yeah, we don't know the name of that racing game, but they had a steering wheel and the pedals.
Yeah.
Like a true racer, we were racing in Pimax
and
with the increase.
We were really bad at it. But we went for the headset.
Talk about yourself.
So that's okay.
Okay. An interesting thing, which I didn't know before, the Pimax headset actually has three field of view modes. I don't know if you knew that too.
I didn't know.
There's a small FOV mode, which is 120°. And then there was the normal mode with 150°. And the large mode with 170°. So the Pimax headsets actually have 200° field of view, but you have these three modes. So the normal FOV was 150, and that is the mode that we tried the headset on.
Yeah.
And you can change the toggle the modes because I think some people, they don't need that high field of view sometimes.
Yeah.
And then they have like the lenses, and the lenses, they are custom made. And if you choose a smaller FOV, they just blacken out
the sides.
Yeah,
they
like
do.
Software, like with the software or programmatically. So that's an interesting thing to know. But let's, before we move on to more technical aspects and specifications and exterior, let's talk about the differences between the specifications of the 5K Plus and the 8K first.
Here I listed the biggest differences between both Pimax headsets that we tested and also two HTC Vive headsets. The Oculus Rift is a lot like the original HTC Vive, so I didn't list it here. I didn't want to overload you with information. What most important is the differences between the lenses. The Pimax uses a custom-made lens, while the Vive headsets uses Fresnel lenses that are OLED. So it has better black colors than the Pimax headsets. The resolution is immensely different though, and much bigger on the Pimax headsets. This means better sharpness and less screen door effect. The refresh rate is almost the same, except the Pimax 8K has a lower one. The difference in field of view is huge here. We will talk more about it in just a bit. The audio is almost the same, except the HTC 5 Pro has built-in headphones. Minimum specs is different too. A better PC is needed for the Pimax headsets.
So I guess what will be interesting now is to tell you about the prices, right?
I have listed the most popular headsets here from the most expensive to the cheapest. We calculated the prices with only the HMD and also with the needed base stations and controllers for a room-scale VR experience. experience. As you can see, the Pimax 8K headset is the most expensive and the Oculus Rift is the cheapest. It's worth to note here that you only need the HMD if you already own a 5 and thus the base stations and controllers. What surprised me here the most is the Pimax 5K Plus is cheaper than the HTC 5 Pro, while the 5K Plus seemed to offer more in terms of specifications. So it looks like here that if you want to upgrade from an older headset, the 5K Plus is in terms of price the most worth for your money. You might wonder, what about the differences between the 5K Plus and 8K headsets? We'll talk about it in just a bit.
But so, we will talk about what we think would be best later in the video, in the conclusion. But one thing that is also interesting is that Pimax also provides a base station and wireless controller kit. And the wireless controllers actually look like the Steam VR Knuckles, which is interesting. You could actually hold them and then release them. But on the website it says you need $300 for that whole kit, but it's a deposit. I have no idea what that means. I don't know if they mean that it's not out yet and you would have to deposit it or something.
I do think it's probably something like that. Because I haven't seen, or have you seen any videos about it? We haven't. So I think that's probably what they mean with that.
They didn't even have this Pimax controllers at the event either. So we didn't try that at all. So let's just stick with the 5 prices, right? The 5 and the Pimax.
Yeah, for now.
So yeah, pretty expensive.
So you're probably wondering what our impression is of the headsets. Well, let's start with exterior, I would say.
So the 5K Plus and the 8K headsets both have the same exterior, so the same buttons, same inputs. It's all exactly the same.
They're twins. They're just the same.
So we'll talk about both of them right now.
Yeah.
Let's start with the audio, right?
Yeah, so the audio. As you probably already noticed, the Pimax doesn't have an own headset, just like the HTC 5 Pro has or the Oculus. But you do get an input on the headset itself.
Yes. No built-ins, but yeah, you can use like your own Bluetooth headset. Whatever, but we didn't try that out during the event because they didn't have anything for us there, so we can't say anything about the audio. However, the buttons, like there are a couple of buttons on the headset. One of the buttons that is very important to have on this headset is the IPD dialer.
Yeah.
So the distance between your lenses, you can just change that, and it's very important to do that here. I don't know if you saw any difference when you changed the IPD dialer?
I did, because you also have like such a huge field of view. It's really important that your IPD is set correctly, just so you're able to see everything like quite well.
Yeah, not blurry.
Yeah,
it was very blurry for me until I set my IPD, and I am I think lower than 60 millimeter, but the IPD dialer of the Pimax doesn't go lower than 60, but 60 was fine for me. It was great. I don't know what your number was.
I did something like 68, so that's quite high. And it was there, so that's kind of nice that I could change it to the one that's best for my eyes.
So I guess this may be a good starting point to go to the lenses too. So once you changed the IPD, what did you think of the screen, of the lenses, of what you saw?
I liked it. The thing that you noticed straight away is a field of view. It's like, it's really nice. You maybe won't notice how huge or like how big the difference is in comparison to like the HTC 5 or the Oculus straight away if you just put on the headset itself, like the Pimax headset. But once you change back to the Oculus or the HTC 5 after trying out the Pimax, you definitely notice the huge difference, the field of view.
Yes, Oculus Rift has 110 degrees field of view.
Yeah.
And the field of view that we tried out with the Pimaxes is 150.
Yeah.
And that is already an immense difference. We didn't notice it until we tried out the Oculus Rift right after we tried the Pimax.
Yeah.
And wow, I kind of felt a little bit more like claustrophobic or something in the Oculus Rift straight away. But it's not like I can't get used to it again, because at home we only have the Oculus and HTC 5 with 110 degrees field of view, and it's fine right now. I can totally just use it again and it doesn't matter, it doesn't feel claustrophobic at all. But if you try it like straight away after each other,
you'll definitely notice it.
It's just an immense difference, right?
Yeah, it's really a huge difference. Because your normal field of view in real life is like, it's huge of course because you see everything, but When you put on the Pimax, it's almost the same as what you see in real life. Like, it's such a good field of view.
Yes.
So yeah,
I do still see a little bit of black sides.
Yeah.
Online, I read about that our eyes In real life, they have about a field of view of 200 degrees.
Yeah.
So that is about, this is more than the 150 that we tried out. So you did see a bit of black lines, like the top and all the, at the bottom.
Yeah, top and bottom. It's more,
noticeable. And if you really do your best and like look to the left while your head is straight, you can still see like the black lines over there too. But I also noticed distortion at the sides of the lenses.
Yeah.
So the Pimax has an interesting lenses. They have custom made lenses for the headset because these lenses don't really exist right now, except they had to make it themselves, and they are called CLPL, customized low persistence build, and they are, by the way, not OLED lenses, so it's not completely true black, but I wanted to tell you that these lenses, they are custom made because in the headset they are a little bit bent. So that means because they are a little bit bent, you can see distortion on the sides of the game that you're playing. So I did notice that a lot though. Did you notice that as well?
Yes, since we're doing a racing game where you move a lot, I did notice that as well. Like mostly like if you're driving, you can see it in the sides. It's a little bit, you do notice that when you're moving fast. Or anyway, I did. When I moved a little bit slower, I noticed it a little bit less. But I think it depends on the game probably
as
well.
Is it very noticeable when you're just playing the game, you think?
It's hard to say.
To me, it isn't really noticeable when I'm really just focused on the game. I don't really look to the sides while my headset is at the front. I usually move my whole head with the headset. Yeah. So then it doesn't really matter. But if you're looking for it, you'll see it. And if sometimes it can get me a little bit off track or something, because the distortion, if I move my head around, I'm looking at the distortion, it's not super comfortable to me.
Yeah.
But that is my experience.
No, I know what you mean.
It's like, it's not a deal breaker.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's noticeable.
And now what about the screen door effect?
Screen door effect?
Yeah.
Well, I did notice it. I can see it, but only when I'm really looking for it. Like when I press the menu and I have a dark background, I can see a bit of screen door effect. What about you?
Same. I didn't notice it straight away because when I was playing the racing game, it was really bright. So I didn't notice it straight away. But once you're in a little bit darker environment than the headset, you'll notice it's there. It's not that bad, to be honest. It was almost not noticeable. So that's definitely a big plus point there.
Did you notice a difference here between the 8K headset with a bigger resolution and the 5K plus
with the 8K headset? It was less. I did notice that the screen door effect was less with that headset.
Honestly, I didn't notice much difference.
Okay, it just there. Was. Oh, I did notice it was a little bit less.
Okay, the resolution is a lot bigger, right, on the 8K and the 5K plus. However, in my experience, I did not notice much difference when using the both headsets. Like when reading text or just playing the game, both resolutions kind of look the same to me. Both super clear, super nice. I could read text super well, but I did not notice like a big difference there between the two resolutions. What about you?
Now that you mentioned reading text and both headset, that went quite well. I have to admit the same thing. Like it went quite well. Also the resolution difference I didn't notice much of that either. Yeah. So even though the 8K has a better resolution, I don't know. I didn't notice it straight away.
All right.
They were both quite well, so that's definitely a big plus for the 5K. Anyway, I always thought the headset looked big in front, but I don't know how they did it, but with the straps and everything, it was actually balanced quite well on your head. Even though they don't have like any headset like here, like with the HTC5, like the old HTC5 with the Deluxe Audio Strap, it is actually really well balanced because the Deluxe Audio Strap is a little bit more, it weighs a little bit more than the normal strap, and then you have the headset in front that's a little bit heavier, but it weighs really like, it's done really well because the audio strap is also like
heavier.
But with the Pimax, you don't have like a heavy strap or anything, but still it felt really balanced. So they've done really well with that.
It's a flexible straps, by the way, just like the original HTC5 without the Deluxe Outer Strap. There are flexible straps that you can just make tighter on the sides and on the top. But yeah, I agree with that. I did not notice any weight, front heaviness or anything.
Yeah, it was balanced really
perfect.
Well.
Perfect, it was nice. Even though that headset looks super huge.
Yeah, it looks like really...
kind of look like an alien or something. Or like a robot or something. But I didn't think it was bad or anything.
Yeah.
felt good. I have a bigger head than Cherry, by the way. Cherry is like a small head. So it was nice to see if it would fit both of our heads. And it was comfortable, super nice. And I could make everything clear by just adjusting the straps. Did not need anything else at all.
Same here.
So as for weights, I guess, do you think it weights more than the other headsets?
That's hard to say. We were not able to try out the 5 straight away, so I'm not totally sure. I do think the 5 is heavier, but I'm not totally sure because I wasn't able to check them out after each other.
Yeah, so I guess it's not noticeable if it's like way heavier. It's definitely not way heavier than the other headsets. But because we don't own the headset here at home, we cannot weigh it, which we normally do for our reviews. So we can't really say whether one of the two is heavier or not. Maybe we should go further then, talk about the tracking. And then the differences between the two headsets could be interesting too.
So the tracking, with the, Cass and I tried both headsets, as mentioned before, of course. With the 5K, we didn't have any trouble with tracking. We did have a few problems with the 8K headset though, but we don't know why we had trouble with that.
Yeah, that could be an issue with like Steam VR or the setup over there. The VR Space employee over there, they said that maybe one of the base stations was broken or something, but they had to test it out a little bit. There was some trouble with the 8K headset there with the tracking, but then with the steering wheel, which didn't track anymore. But it wasn't really the tracking of the headset itself. So the tracking actually worked super fine. Like we are used to room scale tracking. I actually also played a little bit of Skyrim VR with the 5K plus, and it worked really nice. Could attack everyone, could kill everyone perfectly. So that is what you need it for, right?
So in other words, the headset works well with the base stations of the 5.
Yeah.
They work well together, as expected.
We've been talking about both headsets and what they are similar in. Very similar. They are very similar, except for the differences we stated before.
Yeah.
But I think there were a bit of differences. Like, we did mention before that higher resolution did not matter much. Did you think there was any other differences between the 5K headset and the 8K?
It's something I noticed, but I think it's different for each person. Like, when I went from the 5K headset to the 8K headset, because we tried the 8K headset after the 5K one, I noticed that the sides were a little bit more blurry.
Yeah.
On the 8K one. But
that's
interesting.
I did too.
But I'm not sure if that's like for everyone it's different, because they did say it's different for a lot of people. But
it seems very individual, because we were talking about with the people who were testing it over there, and there were a lot of mixed feelings between everyone.
Yeah.
Like some people really preferred the 8K and some people really preferred the 5K plus.
Yeah.
It seems like it's different per person. Like it seems like everyone has had a different feel, because maybe everyone has different eyes. I don't know. Maybe that sounds a little bit stupid, but it does seem that way. Like it's super individual. It depends on what your vision is like, I guess. Because for me as well, and for Cherry, the 8K seemed blurrier.
Like
seemed
the sides, harder to get not the like setup. When you look in front, but just the sides seemed more blurry.
Yeah, more distorted.
Yeah, more distorted. Yeah.
Yeah, that was interesting, right?
But Sweetfire, we did mention that 8K has different sort of resolution. Like it's not like blocks. And the pixels are different. It's not in blocks, but it's in lines. Like that's why it can be different. He mentioned that. That's maybe why it's different for everyone the way they see it.
We are going to move to the real conclusion after a couple of things that I wanted to mention too, and which were concerns that we have about Pimaxes. Let me just give you a little bit of background first. Pimax started on Kickstarter 2 years ago, and there were a lot of people believing in them. They had big promises, so they had their goal reached, which is very cool, and I'm happy for that. However, they kept on delaying the orders, the shipments, but not long ago they actually started shipments for the backers, which is awesome news. And also they have proven to us now that we have tried it that they did it, but like they can do what they were telling us about on the Kickstarter. So that is great news. However, when the pre-order started on the website went down, and that concerns me a little bit, because I feel like as a developer myself, you need to have a good website, especially if you are selling a high-end expensive headset like this. You need to secure your website, and I don't think it's that hard at all to get a good webmaster and a good web hosting and secure the whole website. However, it's still, they didn't really pay attention to that, and the website got hacked for a very long time. They did not fix it, and that just concerns me because it feels like they don't have, or they don't want to spend a lot of money on the website. And that makes me wonder if they will be able to have enough resources for support, for example. That is one of my biggest concerns. I don't know if Pimax has enough resources to provide really good support if you buy the headset.
Yeah, I agree with that because the headset, I would just say it's expensive, but it's a high-end headset. And of course, if you buy something like that, you want to be sure that you get good support as well if there's something is wrong, or if you're going to buy it, that the website is working well, of course, because you're going to buy something, it's a company you know you don't know yet, so it's not like Oculus or HTC Vive who has more headsets already, so it's, you want to be sure that you're going to buy something and everything is going well. So I definitely agree with that. So also something else you have to keep in mind, HTC and Oculus have their headset out for a while now. So you know that they're really up to date with their updates. So it always works well with Steam or with Oculus Home. It works good. Pimax is still new, so you don't know how well they're updating their headsets all the time. If it's always working with Steam, if that's a problem. So that's something you have to keep in mind if you're getting the headset that you don't know.
Yeah, it might need a lot of configuration. As we saw during the demo, it's just a headset that just needs configuration. You need to know how to configure everything just to suit your needs.
Yeah.
So you'll be spending time on that. So you should definitely be aware of that. So yeah, that is our main concern about this. And also, this is not really a concern, but just a little bit of for your information. Backers also get their headset first, and they don't have a lot of units shipped yet. So if you want to buy it now, it might take a long time before you actually get your headset. So that's something to
keep in mind,
be aware of. Yeah. So it's time for our final thoughts on this first impressions video of the Pimax. Well, I have to say, we don't have the Pimax here at home, so we cannot test it out like we usually do for our reviews. So this is really just the first impressions thoughts conclusion. Yeah. You can go first, maybe.
I can go first.
Okay, let's talk. Someone asked on YouTube, is the field of view worth the difference?
Okay, in my opinion, I would say, because in our case, we already have like a setup, so we only need the headset, so we have the base station controls already. I have to admit, after trying out the headset, it's hard to not to want to buy it. It's like the field of view is really nice. It's really nice, believe me. It's so nice to have that, like such a huge field of view. So yeah, I would say my opinion, and if you have the money, of course, and if you still need like an upgrade headset to upgrade to, it's definitely one to look into. I would definitely say that. Like if you have a few headsets you want to check out, I will definitely put this one on your list as well.
Yes. In my opinion as well, the field of view is immense. It's nice, it's cool. I played Skyrim VR in this field of view, and I was like standing on top of a rock or something on purpose to look at the view of Skyrim. It was just so incredible, so different from playing it on Oculus Rift. So I think if you already have the HTC Vive, like Cherry said, so you have the base station and the controllers already, and you're looking for an upgrade, I would think I would get the Pimax 5K Plus instead of the 5 Pro, just because of the field of view. Because then you pay $700 extra, just that. However, if you're completely new to VR and you don't have the base station, I do think it's super expensive. I don't know if that is really worth the price, to be honest. Yeah. I don't know if I would pay, what was it, $1,400 or $1,200 just for that increased field of view, if I can also get like an Oculus Rift for $400. Or the original HTC Vive for $600 with everything, with controllers and base stations. I mean, that field of view is crazy enough. It's, if you're new to VR, that is already very awesome. Like, I'm still able to go back to that field of view and still enjoy myself. So, if you are on a budget, I would not recommend getting the Pimax just yet. I would get an Oculus Rift or HTC Vive since they are as fun, and wait until more headsets come out with a bigger field of view, because they most likely will.
But I think
competition is good, right?
Yeah, competition is good, for sure.
I'm so happy that Pimax actually were able to pull this off, and they proved that. I think because they did this, I think HTC and Oculus, I hope they will step up and also create a headset with a bigger field of view now.
Ooh, that would be nice.
That would be awesome, right? So let's want to move on to the personal preference now, or?
Okay, for sure.
Our final thoughts. I guess the final conclusion in this. We've said it already.
I would say I wouldn't mind if Cass and I would get the 5K one, to be honest.
5K
because
plus.
Yeah, because the field of view is so nice.
Yeah, I don't know why, but just the 8K is not that big of a difference with the 5K plus for us.
Like the difference in impact wasn't that big. So that's why the 5K plus is, I would be happy with that one as well.
But as mentioned before, it's personal preference and
yeah,
it's individual too. So I would suggest to find a place to try out both headsets to see which one suits you more. Because as Cherry said before, the lenses seem to be built different, or the pixels, something like that.
Yeah.
And it could be that the 8K suits your eyes better.
Yeah, so definitely if you have the chance, what Cass just mentioned, just check them out, because maybe the 8K is the one for you. Maybe you like that one way more, it has a way bigger impact. So just check them out if you have the chance, for sure.
All right, so here's the end of our first impression video and the second episode of Dive into VR of Pimax. Pimax, yes. And well, I want to thank all of you for watching this video. If you have any questions at all of the Pimax or anything that we didn't cover in this video, let us know down below. We will answer them definitely in the comment section, or maybe on Discord if you want to come to chat with us too.
Because the link for our Discord is down below as well.
Yes, and as always, one special thanks goes to our Patreons. Thank you guys for being there for us. And if you want to explore more VR with us, Cass and Cherry, then make sure to subscribe and hit that bell to not ever miss anything from us anymore. And well, we are Cass and Cherry VR. She's Cherry, I'm Cass.
And we say VR
on.
On.
Why did I just touch your face? I don't know why I did that.
Cass and I went to Gouda, which is actually a... But why did we went to Gouda? You would ask. I will say that because... Oh, never mind. It was echt zo slecht. But hello everyone. Anyway, that's not how we start.